Hey, Lewis Turner here for Guitar Interactive magazine, back with another guitar review. And this one, we're checking out the very gorgeous looking Godin Core CT. And here it is. So you heard it there at the start. We go through some of the different features, starting down the headstock, and then we'll hear some of the different sounds that we can get from this particular model. So starting down here, we've got the gloss covered headstock, which looks very cool with the Godin name on the top there, and the actual name of this particular model. Looks very nice. Let's flip it over and have a look at the back. Godin's own tuners on here, which work really nicely, nice and solid, and they're adjustable should they start to come loose over lots of time. And on the back, we've got a mahogany set neck, as you can see there, and the set neck joint, which looks very cool. We'll come to the body in a bit, that's a little bit special. Flip it back round. On this one, we've got a rosewood fingerboard with nice large perloid dots, so you can see where you're going. A very nice, comfortable neck, quite thin, very playable, nice action on this particular model. Just a nice way to get around. And despite, you know, this common shape guitar that we've got here, there's plenty of upper fret access I can get with the large cutaway for the bottom horn here. I can get right at the top. And also, I don't know if we can see this on camera, we've got a nice little scalloped kind of edge here, so your thumb fits perfectly for your thumb to get right at the top there, which is really nice. As you might expect with this shape, we've got the pickup selector switch at the top here, three-way switch. The pickups will come back to in a second. This tailpiece is particularly cool because they've gone for the wraparound string option on the tailpiece. You know, there's a lot of arguments about this sort of tailpiece, whether you go straight through or do the wraparound effect. Wraparound seems to be winning at the minute for keeping things in tune and intonation and those kind of things, and seems to be working a treat on this particular guitar. Four controls, and this particular model we've got a chambered Spanish cedar body. So what that basically means is, you know, it's not technically a solid wood guitar, so it makes it very light and it makes it very resonant. So really lots of sustain from this guitar, and those kind of those sounds that you'd associate with like an F-hole type guitar, you can kind of get with this. And also a nice feature on this that I particularly like, and with this high gloss maple covered top here, is we've got the beveled edges, the curved edges, so it makes it nice and comfortable to play rather than just having it, you know, the normal kind of, not sharp, but, you know, the pointed edges rather than these curved ones. That makes it nice and comfortable. So it's a real joy to play this particular model. Two humbucker pickups on this guitar. So in the neck, we've got Godin's own GHM1. And in the bridge, a very common one that you see on a lot of guitars and a lot of players opt for is the Seymour Duncan 59. Tried and tested. You know, pick up for many years now. And you heard a little bit of the both at the start, so just go through some of the controls. Obviously it depends on how, what pickup you're using. So let's start with the bridge here. So the bridge control is our Seymour Duncan 59. So a real bright cutting rock kind of sound. I've only got a little bit of crunch on the amp here. This kind of tone sounds great, and then we got the tone control next to it. Sorry, down there, and I can roll down. There's different sounds. So the 59 is a real tried and tested treasure. I really like them, I've got them on a couple of guitars. They sound great for that kind of rocky stuff and the high gain sounds, they work really well. Perfect in the bridge for cutting through. So then we have the middle switch, which is obviously out of phase in between the two. And so that gives us, with everything on 10, that gives us this kind of sound. Nice and mellow. In fact, on a slightly cleaner sound, which I might be able to do by rolling the volume down, that'd make a good rhythm pickup. And then finally onto the neck pickup, which will be the new one to a lot of your ears, which is this Godin GH-M1 pickup, which I used a little bit at the start there. So we'll just play with this a bit. That sounds really great to my ears. I really love the sound of that. It just makes me want to play blues. It's got that very, it's kind of scooped, bassy sound, and obviously being helped along by the chambered body as well. So we get a really nice warm tone from it that really resonates well. You know, I'm not playing next to a speaker cab or anything in a minute. It's just natural guitar sustain that you're hearing. Great, really nice warm sounds there from that Godin pickup. A well-balanced guitar, despite how it may look with the sizable headstock. It's because it's a short scale guitar as well, so it's not a particularly long neck. It sits nicely, and as I mentioned before, a really nice weight to it. So, you know, it's comfortable standing or sitting, and I'm a big fan of light guitar, so this is great for me. Let's go through some of the different sounds once again, so you can just hear some of the different variations through the pickups. So lots of different tonal options from this particular model, making it ideal for lots of different scenarios. You know, I can hear it being used for rock, I can hear it being used for funk and soul, and that neck pickup really cuts through nicely, so you could use it as a good jazz guitar, and I guess, you know, up to metal, so it's a really versatile instrument. Really nice and easy to play. I personally think it looks amazing, beautifully finished throughout. It's been a real joy to have the pleasure of playing and reviewing this guitar. So this has been the Godin Core CT. Excellent, versatile, easy to play instrument that sounds fantastic. I recommend you go and check one out. Thanks for watching.